Usually somebody always asks, why did you do it? Or what got you going on it? Well, I don't know, some of you know Ron Suitsman. And he's won the hiker, when I first joined, he won it every year. And he had like 260, I think 270, 300, I don't know. And I thought, wow, I'll never get that. I'm not even gonna try. And as I retired and started thinking about I can hike more, I thought, I've heard other people do this, maybe I could do it. Maybe it's something I could actually do. So my husband, which is Tom over there, bought into it. And he said he would support me because I am not a backpacker. I never even considered myself a hiker until I did join 7 years ago. It's been 7 years. And didn't even consider myself a hiker. I walked, I bike, whatever, but I never hiked in the woods. So this was new to me. And Mary Rebert, who is not here tonight, she invited me to come to a meeting. I had just met her maybe 6 months, a year ago, before that. And our chapter hosted the national convention. And she needed volunteers. So she said, would you help volunteer? And I said, oh, that sounds like fun. I think I could do that. And then she said, by the way, we're going to Dayton in a month to go to that convention, so we see how it runs. So she and I have gone to every one since. So I've gotten to hike in all the states that the North Country Trail goes through.
Which are
North Dakota, Minnesota, Wisconsin, Michigan, now I've hiked in EP, Ohio, Pennsylvania, New York.
And Minnesota.
And this, and what?
Minnesota.
Yeah, I thought I said it.
I think you said it.
Okay. And this year it's in Hocking Hills, Ohio, and then next year it's in Michigan again at Shanty Creek. So many of you who've never gone to one, it's a great experience. And I've met a lot of you there at the conference. It's fun to see people from all over the country, and you get to see them, a lot of them every year. It's really a good experience.
Thanks for the question.
So I do not backpack. I don't own one. And I'm not sure I want to. I'm not sure I really want a backpack. One person had suggested, if you're going to do it, don't do it just one night. Because if that night it rains, then you have a bad experience. So you gotta do at least two or three nights. So we'll see. So I just carried a day pack with water and snacks. And my trusty husband was with me the whole time, except for a few hikes that I did with our group here. And then I did another one with a friend. So other than that, I did them by myself.
Wow.
And I started on New Year's Day, the New Year's Day hike, and that was like a mile. And then I ended up taking 36 different days. So one hike was a mile, and my longest was 28. So my average was 17. But when I went out, we would look at the forecast to see what the weather might be. Gee, this week I've got 2-3 days here. I'd look at that, and then that's when I would try to plan my hikes. I wasn't always successful in the weather category. So I did all the local area first, our own chapter first, and after we start driving 2 hours to get for me to hike for the day and then drive 2 miles or 2 hours back, we decided it was time for a motel. So I spent one night with a cousin who lives near Ohio, one night with a friend, 2 nights in Montague, 3 nights in Manistee, 4 in Calcasca and 5 in Point Falls and Petoskey and Mackinac City, split it up between those three areas. I'm using this because this was all, I was already a year ago, so this is, I gotta have some reminders. So, I really followed the spring. I was done in June 24th. So I followed spring, which was really cool, because I have never seen so many wildflowers in my life. It was wonderful. And Sheila back there, I went on a hike at Pierce Cedar Creek with her, and she knew all these wildflowers, and I was so impressed, and I thought, I've got to learn a few. So I have a few, but that's not much. So I saw a few different ones. So that was one of the most impressive things I've seen, is the wildflowers. They were everywhere. And I think part of it was a wet spring. And it was very wet the whole time. So I got to have wet feet, like most hikers love to have. So I got to have lots of wet feet. And I used a lot of newspapers to dry them out. And that works really, really well. So I think that spring is a good time. I think I had 2 days with mosquitoes, and that was it. And one day they were really bad, and I hadn't bought a netting because I didn't know if I would need one. They were so bad that when I met my husband for lunch, we had to keep the windows closed. It was warm out, but they were so bad. They were just swarming everywhere. So that was one of my, but it was only where we really ate. I don't think I had them that bad, but they just happened to be there. I don't know, maybe it was Tom. And I copied all the maps. I had maps. I like a visual. I got to have it in front of me. And I copied them and I kept marking off, and I thought, oh, I can do this. You know, I'm getting there. I'm marking them off. The maps are not always accurate. So the blue blazes are really, really important. Going on. I'm starting at the back here, and Tom had a split there, and in the park by the bridge, we had a toast. So that's what that picture is, and there's Tom with me. Now, I asked him if he wanted to say anything tonight, and he didn't. But he was in the car, and many times he listened to a lot of books on tape, but he would sometimes put the seat back and he's on a road and his head's back and his mouth's open. And he had multiple people stop to make sure he was okay.
Several of them had his funny lights on the top of the car. They were all friendly.
Yeah. And they had asked them, so then you got to preach about the North Country Trail. And some of them knew about it and some of them didn't. So he was an ambassador doing that.
Good for you, Tom.
All right. Okay. Now, I don't know if anybody else, we could not figure out where the trail ends in Mackinac City. We never saw anything that said, it's done.
The end.
The end. So we took a picture here. This could be the end. It could be where there's a phone that you can call so you can get a ride over the bridge. We thought, well, maybe that's the end. I don't know where the end is.
So how close is this to the bridge?
This is not that far, but it's not right there. It's, okay. You know, across the street a little bit.
I don't know.
We couldn't figure it out. We never, you know, and I did some retracing a couple times to see if I'd missed a blaze. I never could figure it out. So, okay. I think we're trying to get rid of all the stuff. So kiosks were a lot of fun to read, and there were a lot of good information. And I must say that I had, over the years that I've been hiking, well, I did a lot of the sections, but I had never done them all. So there was a lot of new trail that I had not seen.
Full screen.
Full screen. Go down to
right there.
Right there. There you go.
Okay.
It cuts off the top and bottom, but.
Yeah, it cuts off. This is in Wilderness State Park, and I had never been in Wilderness State Park. I'd heard about it, and I had no idea what was there. But last year was a very wet spring like this year, so there were a lot of trees tipped over. Lots of water to walk through, but this was the trail. You kind of had to go like this to get that trail. This is more just in Wilderness. I think this was in Wilderness. As I said, it's been a year and I kept track, but I don't always know. Go ahead. But it's close to it if it wasn't.
That's why I can't play.
It's what lake?
White Camp Lake. That's the bridge that you come over. It's just put by crossbow.
Okay. So there was all kinds of different ways to get over water, so I like this one because it had cement.
Is that a blaze?
Pretty sturdy to me that would hold me to get over there with a blue blaze on the end. This was in Wilderness. And you can see the growth. There are a lot of ferns. I really enjoyed this park a lot. And this always made me feel like it was a fairyland. With all the ferns and the green, and you could just see the trail going through it. I really like when the trail kind of looked like that. There was a lot of it. Tom took a picture of me every morning, so this, I look pretty refreshed here, so this was a start. And there are always different ways of marking the trail, and when I first started, if you're not used to looking for where the trail is, you drive right by it and you don't even know it. But when you're walking, they're pretty evident. So Tom became a very excellent finder of the trail. He knew exactly where to go. And there's the blue blazes there. Yeah.
Driving at 2 miles an hour helps too.
So if you're on the trail, and I'll interject here, if you're on the trail, and can you back up, Tom?
I can back up.
Okay, so if you're on the trail and you see two blue blazes down at the bottom, and you know that the one up at the top goes, you're gonna take the trail to the left. So if you are new hiking the North Country Trail, and if you've done this many, many times, I apologize, but anyway, a lot of people don't know. So when you're hiking the North Country Trail, the blue blazes help you to know where to go.
Sometimes it's pretty evident, other times you wouldn't have a clue. So they're really helpful.
We don't generally try to put a turn place on a Carsonite post like that. That's why the little arrow at the top is.
Yeah, it worked too. Okay. Keep going.
Sorry. He's on break. He must be unionized.
That's right.
And they said lots of water, and the lily pads were just coming out there. This would have been in June, so later in the year.
That's it.
Okay.
And these are called lady slippers. All right. I had never seen any before. I was on that hike with Sheila there, and they were abundant in Wilderness. Okay.
I'm pressing the button.
Okay, go ahead.
You want the lights back on?
No, it has nothing to do with it.
There you go.
And here's some more wildflowers that were coming up. I don't know if somebody knows the names or not, but. With
yellow
the
ones.
Huh? Okay.
Oh, no. No, those are my legs and Lily.
Just ask them. They'll tell you.
Well, we down the corner.
Yes. The top is kind of cut off, but signs are very important. Because there are areas where there's more than just the North Country Trail. And you have to make sure, you know, you want to follow the right trail, because you could end up who knows where, so. And there are so many variation in signs, they're kind of interesting, okay? You can see some trees down here, but some days this is the way it looked.
You were walking pretty early in the season, did you see a lot of downed trees?
Lots, lots and lots and lots. This is another trail through here that I thought was so interesting. It's just beautiful. And water everywhere. Michigan has lots of water. Lakes or ponds or wood ponds or whatever you want to call it. Look what I saw.
Anybody know what that bug is called?
Stone.
It's what 10-year-old girls and boys do. Is go and plant stones and then people have to go find them. That's the latest game.
Oh, really? Seriously? Do they have a map to find them?
There's another version over there, probably the same one, I don't know, but. Now, you'll see that my poles are here. I use my poles a lot. And around here, I don't necessarily use them, but they were a lifesaver for me, and I'll show you in some areas why. Fungus.
Is it red lobster?
Red lobsters?
Fungus.
I don't. Trail boxes, trail logs, there's a trail box, usually a section, they'll all look alike, but every different chapter that maintains, they tend to have different log boxes. And log boxes are fun, because you can look at them and see who was there just ahead of you. And our director last year, he retired, was Bruce, and Andrea had another position, was she trails?
It's trails director.
Yeah, trails director. And I happened to hike in a section the day after they did. Wow. And I knew that Andrea, when we were in Lowell, had said they were gonna check out places for the conference in 2019. And it was right when she had said they were going to go check them out. So I'm assuming they did some hiking while they were doing that. Okay.
Yes.
This was the last week that I hiked, and we were only going to stay so many days, like 4 days. And my husband over there said, you know, if you walk so many more miles per day, and if we add on a day, then you can be done. Oh. And that sounded pretty nice. So I decided I needed a day off. So this was our day off in Leela.
Oh.
It was great. Outside of our motel room. I opened the window and there it was.
That's not your license plate.
Yeah, I love it. That says no, we're not getting the whole slide, but that was on the trail. I don't know if they were serious about no trespassing. There were also some beautiful benches and walkways and boardwalk. So if I saw a different one, I was taking a picture of it just so that I knew what some of them looked like. This is Petoskey. Petoskey goes along the river, or along Lake Michigan, and that is a beautiful, beautiful area. And so you get to look at the water for miles. And the next picture, I think, shows the whole trail. That's a wonderful bike trail, and it's all, that is just a beautiful park with lots of bathrooms. It's wonderful.
Not too many trees around that area.
Okay. And this was in town, and they had Carson Eggs right in town. Nick, look at that. I hadn't, you know, we don't use them in town, so I was, I'd seen that. So, and this is outside of town, and the trail was right next to that, and then look where the trail is. The next picture. The stones. The stones were the trail.
Oh.
Getting across the water.
So that's why you needed your poles.
Yes, it helps you get over those, get through those. I didn't know Arden Johnson. Did you, Larry, by any chance?
I don't think so.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, somebody back here.
So here was a plastic bench in memory of Arden. This is a preserve outside of Petoskey, and I had never been in this section. It was just winding through pine trees like this. That was a very pleasant surprise. I didn't expect that. Another great sign, if you can see at the bottom, it tells you how far it is to North Dakota and Vermont, which is always fun to see when you're hiking. And then it talks about some other trails. See, there's some other trails. So again, you need to know where you're headed, so you know which you're headed in the right direction. Okay. I don't know. I don't know these things, but they're all interesting to me. They're all interesting. There's the trail.
Wow.
That's the trail.
The water?
The water is the trail. So
you walk in the water?
Well, I tried to not walk in the water.
Walk on the water?
Now the next picture. You can see how the water, this is running down the side, and on your right is the trail. So the water was running from one side to the other over the trail, and they had put some boards or wood there at one time. And you can see they cut a tree there recently also. And that's the trail, the water running right down it and then down the side.
Was that trail pretty well marked?
Yeah, everywhere, I mean, generally everywhere, there's a few spots that weren't so good, but this was good. Yes, it was good.
Nice.
Look at, there's a, what's that creepy
frog?
It's a slug.
Yep.
And I saw a lot of these trees, the trail marked on it and fallen over. But it still meant you keep going on that trail. You knew where you were in the right spot. What are those called?
Beach drops.
What is it? Where do they count?
I heard beach drops.
Beach drops.
Beach drops, okay. There's another good sign right at the road, so I knew where to go. And there's a blue blaze.
Early in the morning, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, early in the morning.
Yeah, very early in the morning. I'm completely dry. This is Boynton City.
After the wine?
No, this is not the day.
Look for the wine.
One of the things that I really, we both enjoyed, we were in areas we had never been before. You know, we had never gone through these towns or spent time in them. And we were able to, you know, we had our evening and we would usually I would for sure get a shower and then we would go explore the town and what was in the area. And we really enjoyed that.
Did you take souvenirs?
Just pictures, I think.
Yeah. Another sign, I don't know where that one was at the top, I can't see, but just another sign. And so in their chapter, they had a lot of these metal signs made, which are very nice, because they have lots of trails. This is the area that I got to it, where I'm standing, and there was this bridge. But the bridge wasn't attached.
Oh, boy.
So I could see on the other side where it was dry over there, so I thought, well, I gotta get from here to there one way or the other. So I walked pretty darn fast.
In the water?
I had to. I didn't know what else to do. It was like a floating one or something, and it just wasn't attached on that end. It was on the other end, so it was floating. It was on the water.
Oh,
my
gosh.
So now, this is another, obviously you can see that little dirt ground there. That's the trail. So if you didn't see that, you might not have a clue. And the ferns, I have never walked in. I mean, some of them were almost as tall as I was. So if you were there in the morning, you were wet now. Fast. Quick. Yeah, that's nice. It's a great sign. But there were lots of areas. Okay, this is the trail. It's not a sanctioned bridge or anything. It's a watch. There's a bridge that was knocked out. I'm sure that was one of the years they had a bad flood, and they've gone around it, but you can see that how it was demolished. There's the trail. Okay. And there's a great bridge, that big metal bridge. So there's a great bridge. But it was high water, so lots of water. But pretty, nice, it was beautiful. We're not seeing them. Go ahead, Jared. So there's another bridge out. So they had a great sign there to tell you to go around. In this area, there were it was a lot of ledges, and you wound around, and a lot of trees over the trail. So you had to walk around or go above or do a lot. You had to, as we say, survey the scene before you took off, so you could figure out where to go and exactly how to do it. Spring. This is getting close to Manistee, I think. Maybe this is Jordan Valley, more in the Jordan Valley area. Where brochures were there in that particular box.
End of the day.
No, this is morning. Another morning. This one you don't see. My picture, if you showed it this way, it goes all the way to the top of a hill. So that was a way So this is another warning. This is Manistee. So here I'm starting to get into the Manistee area, which I hadn't done in this section. I had never done that before. And this is one of the new murals that we now have.
Oh.
Over the whole trail, and they're different for each section. So if you have a trail in North Dakota, they have a picture that's North Dakota. So they're whatever's in the area. We've got one in Albion, one in Kellogg Forest. This is Kalkaska. I've never seen the fish. I don't think I'd ever been to Kalkaska.
Really?
Generally, when you hear, you can't really see where the trail is. It all looks the same. But you see there's one blue blaze here, but here's the next one. So you know you've got to get from there to there. And that's the way it's supposed to be, right, Mick?
Right, Mick.
Those are some eggshells, and I'm not sure they were laying along the side. So, yeah. This one, this area goes down to that lake, and obviously they've had probably some problems over the years. The next picture, the trail is that sand area. That is the trail. So the sand along the lake is the trail. And it was quite a ways along, and there were some areas that were a little more difficult to get over around water than others. I don't know.
Starvation.
But this is a nice log box. This is a log box, and you unhook that, and then it falls down, and it's like a place to write on.
Oh.
So that was a very
nice
one. There's a.
Is that a beaver?
Yeah, beaver. Yeah.
Did you see any?
I did not see a beaver, but there's the trail right there. You see that?
Oh, my gosh.
It must be the morning.
Must be the morning. Yeah.
Or after wine.
No.
No. No.
Jane?
Yes?
That last picture, was that on top of a beaver dam?
I think so.
Yeah.
Now, one day was probably my worst hiking day. It poured almost all day, and I was wet within like 10 minutes. And the trail, now this looks pretty good here. The horses were allowed, and I guess bikes. And in that section, it was just this wide, but there were bushes on either side, so there was no place to walk unless you were in that, and a horse had gone through fairly recently, so it was all churned up, and so it was like, and you had to, one foot in front of the other was a little more difficult. Sometimes you're on service roads or two tracks.
Some of these roads that I would try to cross Jane's path, and I figured if I had a car or broke down, I would just take my license plate off. Leave the car there because the towing job would be more valuable than the car. And some of the days it was, I had to go through a lot of water, and I was concerned.
Tom, are you painting yourself as a sad, sad husband?
No, I'm a SAG driver.
Not sad. This was through. No, this was along, this is a county fairgrounds, and they had, different groups had sponsored the area to beautify it and do landscaping, and I thought that was cute.
That looks like a baseball or softball.
I know, but it was like a fairgrounds or something.
Is that Kalkaska?
I think it was near Kalkaska. There's the trail. All right. But you can see the grass was starting to grow and the trees were out. That's the trail. That's the trail. Chuck's Place.
Oh, I know where that is.
Sand Lake?
It's in Lake. It's south of Traverse City.
Oh, is it?
Sand Lake's Glen area.
Okay. There were three signs. So here's an advice from an old oak tree. Stand tall and proud. Be content with your beauty. Sink your roots into the earth. Drink plenty of water. Enjoy the view. There are three signs that was in this section, and I thought they were really cool. Now, and there's one of the trail registers that I was really impressed because it's classic, it's blue, it's so wonderful. I thought that would be a good idea. And there's another bench near that area. And if I'm correct, I think this is in the Valley of the Giants. Meaning the trees, yeah. And here, it looks like a beaver dam to me. I'm not an expert, but it looked like to me. And if there were signs that kind of gave you an idea of what road you were on, those were wonderful. So I'm always thankful for Jeff, what he's done in our section. I don't know why I took that one.
Oh, that's cool.
Yes, I know. There you go.
Is that a campground? Or just
no, it was just...
Just along the trail?
Just along the trail. Yeah. Did I read that? Which loop area that they're repairing and so you can't do it this summer? It's not on the North Country Trail, it's on the other part, so you can't do a loop this summer because there's a bridge out or some major area. This is starting along the Manistee River. And this was a whole, I think it was almost a day and a half, and you were up and the views were fantastic, and you were going up and down all day, so it, but it was beautiful. I had never been here before.
Is that the Manistee?
Uh-huh. Okay, here's the river. Immerse yourself in nature, slow down and meander, go around the obstacles. Be thoughtful of those downstream and stay something. That is?
What flower is that?
I don't know. Okay, oh, wow. You've got to show this picture differently, Tom. You've got to show this picture so we can get the whole... They were not facing each other. And you know what's in the Folgers can? Toilet paper, and it was full. There was a whole new roll. So they were ready.
You can tell we're not professionals.
Where do I go?
We do what we can.
I had to try that.
Okay.
That's okay.
Iris, I think pretty. In the morning. Cold.
What?
Got many layers.
A lot warmer than it was this past week.
This was the old trail. Well, first of all, I don't know if you can see this. See this?
Yeah.
And this was the old Indian way from Chicago to Traverse City. It was that path. So I like that.
116 stands for what?
What's that?
I-16. What does 16 stand for?
So the question is, what's the 16? Oh.
Oh, 16.
Some of, I didn't see that many animals as I was hoping I would see.
Some don't move very fast.
I did see a raccoon on the trail. But he moved pretty slow, and then all of a sudden, he must have really realized I was there and really took off around the tree. There's a way to get down to the water, a nice stairs there.
Oh. Karen.
Yep.
Yes.
This was just out in the middle of the woods. Somebody had some time.
Oh, that's
Now this was fabulous. This doesn't do.
All the drillers.
Turned the corner and there this was. It went for a long, long ways. It was just
all the drillers.
That was a very pleasant surprise. This happened to be on one of the roads for quite a while, but that was, sometimes it's welcome.
Oh my goodness.
You can see there's not a green leaf here.
Yeah.
Nothing green.
Early spring, right?
Spring.
Yeah.
This is in near Manistee.
It's between Cadillac and Manistee.
And this is like hardly from here to the parking lot to the trail. So they're real trail supporters, so they had that sign there. Yeah, they obviously knew all about the trail.
Where was it?
Outside of Manistee. It wasn't in a town, it was on the road.
That was my wolf then.
This is Manistee.
Oh, beautiful.
I had never been to that part. This was a logging area, so that was a sign that they had a sawdust pile there at one time. Now, this is my story on these two gentlemen. The one on the left